The trial of Caryn Kelley, the College Park woman, has been charged with manslaughter, accused of shooting her boyfriend to death in July of 2011. State prosecutors say the shooting happened after a night of drinking, followed by arguing. Michelle Meredith is live at the Orange County Courthouse. And Michelle, what was the tone of today's testimony?
Well, it was more or less a day of show and tell, with the state showing just how volatile the evening must have been. The state set the scene for the shooting death of 46-year-old Philip Petros through the use of pictures, and the pictures painted the portrait of a wild night at Caryn Kelley's College Park home on July 27, 2011.
That is a close-up of the bottles of alcohol on the counter.
There were bottles of alcohol in the bar area, in the trash, bottles of prescription pills marked Ambien, pills marked Xanax, a pair of women's underwear on a blanket on the patio in the backyard.
There was a pair of women's panties, and there were also two cigarette butts.
Then came pictures setting the gruesome scene after the shooting, the gun on the floor next to a pillow, the victim's blood-soaked T-shirt, many pictures too graphic to show that seemed to upset the defendant, who often put her head down. In cross-examination, the defense had a line of questioning that indicated the crime scene could have been contaminated, pointed out that Kelley's blood-stained nightgown was tested by FDLE months after the shooting and was something she wore for hours while being questioned by police.
In this particular case, were you told that Ms. Kelley was wearing the nightgown in question for anywhere from 11 to 13 hours after it is believed she may have gotten blood on it?
No, I had no kind of time frame as far as when that item was collected.
Now, a gun residue expert from FDLE testified that based on his findings, he could not tell who fired the gun, Kelley or Petros. Live in Orange County, Michelle Meredith, WESH 2 News.